हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल क्रिएटिव मटेरियल अमेरिका। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेल। सो टुडे आई एम शेयरिंग पॉलीक्रिस्ट रेमेडी ऑफ अ मटेरियल अमेरिका, दैट इज द थूजा ऑक्सीडेंटालिस। इट इज द किंग ऑफ द एंटी साइकोटिक रेमेडी। येस, इट इज द किंग ऑफ एंटी साइकोटिक रेमेडी। इट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट रेमेडी फॉर द मैनिफेस्टेशंस ऑफ साइकोटिक मैनिज्म। Thuja means sacrifice. Thuja, it is the Greek word and the meaning is sacrifice. The wood of this plant or the tree that is burnt into the ancient days to show that the person has been sacrificed for God. That's why the common name of this plant is tree of life. Okay. This plant that is found into the North America, it is a evergreen tree and it grows near around 20 to 50 feet height. Okay, it is flowers into May and the mother tincture it is prepared from that fresh green leaves. So let's move further towards the introductory of this thuja. The source is the vegetable kingdom and it is the plant remedy. The family is Coniferae family. Common name, as we see earlier, that is the sacrifice, tree of life, arbor vitae and the white cedar. Prover is our master Dr. Samuel Hahnemann. Miasm is psychosis. Temperament is lymphatic and sluggish. Thermal is chilly. Physical makeup, that how the thuja patient looks like. So dark hair, dark complexion, oily dirty skin, brown color spots over the body and the warts like growth over the skin. They are basically dirty looking people. So as I said earlier that it is the king of antipsychotic remedies. So now what is a psychotic miasm? So let's see into the brief. That psychotic miasm, it is basically chronic venereal miasm that you will learn into the organon or into the philosophy part. The psychotic miasm, it is developed as a result of the suppression of gonorrhea. Gonorrhea, which is occur into the ancient times, that caused by the Neisseria gonorrhoeae bacteria because of that impure coition. And the symptoms of gonorrhea, they are the thick mucus discharge from the urethra or the vagina or the penis. There is a burning, maturation, dysuria, frequency of maturation is increased, painful coition and pain into the lower abdomen, or there may be a fever. Now the symptoms of the gonorrhea, if not treated properly, then after the several weeks it produces wart like growth or the condylomata or the cauliflower like growth over the genitals. Now these are the primary manifestation of the psychotic miasm. Now if we do suppression of this wart like growth by the process like cauterization, burning, cutting or the ligature, then it leads to secondary manifestation of the psychosis. This is the picture that shows sign and symptoms of gonorrhea. Now move further toward the sphere of action and the pathogenesis. First is the skin. Now on the skin, it produces the psychotic manifestations. Psychotic manifestation, that is basically overgrowth. Overgrowth of any kind of tissue or the organ, hyperplasia, hypertrophy, or in the form of warts, condylomata or the cauliflower-like growth, or a kind of cyst. So on the skin, it produces warts or condylomata. Now unhealthy, dirty looking of the skin, there is a brown pigmentation over the body. Now what is the character of these warts? So warts are large and pedunculated. Eruption seen only on the cover part of the body and sweat is on the uncover part. It is the most important and peculiar feature of the thuja, that is eruption, it is on the covered part and the sweat is on uncovered part. Usually sweat we see on the covered parts. Okay. Now why this happen? Because of the psychotic nature. In the psychotic nature, the main feature is hiding. The symptoms of gonorrhea on the primary manifestation of psychosis also appear first on the genitals. And the genitals usually are covered or the hide. Okay. And the patient also tries to hide the symptoms that whenever it is occur, patient feels embarrassment to go to the physician. So he tried to cut or burn that part, right? Okay. So that's why that is a hiding feature, and the hiding feature also seen at the mental level and the physical level. On the physical level, we see that the eruption is only on the covered part, that it is very ugly, right? The patient feels very shy to show it, so it is occurring to the covered part, so no one can see that, okay? Now, the eruptions, they are burns after scratching. Nails are deformed and brittle. Now, the Boninghausen has found thuja as preventive and curative in the smallpox epidemics. Now, on the second sphere, that is the mucous membrane, it causes irritation, inflammation. Now, on the sexual organ, there will be a copious acrid corroding discharge. Into the female, it is the acrid leucorrhea. Now, the third is the female sexual organ. It leads to dysmenorrhea, ovarietes or leucorrhea-like conditions. In ovarietes, it is usually into the left side, that thuja, it is the prominent left-sided remedy. So all the manifestations start from the left, goes to the right side. So here severe pain into the left ovary, into the left inguinal region, especially when walking or riding. Patient has to sit or lie down, which is aggravated at every menstrual period. Now the leucorrhea is acrid, thick or the greenish. Menses are scanty. There is an extreme sensitivity of the vagina, so it prevents the coition, which is leads to sterility. So it is the most important remedy for the infertility whenever it is a history of the suppressed gonorrhea or the hiding nature, the shyness, the jealousy, and this kind of all the kind of the symptoms, the white light growth, etc. You can think of the thuja. Now on the male sexual organ, it leads to gonorrhea, prostatitis, inflammation of the prepuce and the glans penis. There will be a pain or the burning at the neck of the bladder while the urination. So that is a dysuria, frequent and urgent desire for urination. It is also important remedy for the BPH, that is benign prostatic hypertrophy. Symptoms are the urgency or the frequency. There is a suppressed gonorrhea which leads to articular rheumatism, condylomata or the warts or the penis. Now the urinary organs, on urinary organs, it leads to paralysis of the sphincter. Now because of the paralysis, there will be incontinence of the urine. So patient cannot control the urine. And because of that BPH, there is a constricted urethra. So there is a splits and the small urinary stream. There is a sensation of tickling after the urination and the severe cutting pain. Now on the GIT, it leads to impaired digestion. There will be a constipation, diarrhea, fissure fistula or the warts. Now the constipation, it is the important remedy for the obstinate constipation. The PQRS is stool recedes after being partly expelled. And into the diarrhea, it is early morning diarrhea or after the breakfast, so known as the breakfast diarrhea. The causation is vaccination, onion, tea, coffee, bread butter or the fatty food. Diarrhea is like gushing out from bung hole. So causative factor, that is the most important, as thuja, it is the remedy for the bad effect of vaccination, especially whenever there is a diarrhea. Now the anus is fissured, it is painful to touch, and the fissure, it is surrounded with the flat warts or the moist condylomata. There is a sensation as if something alive moving in the abdomen. So it is a kind of delusion of being pregnant, which is also seen into the sulfur. So now, what are the key features of the thuja that you have to remember? It is first, it is a left-sided medicine. The symptom starts from the left, goes to the right. Second is, it is the king of antipsychotic remedy. So you have to remember the symptomatology of the psychotic miasm. Okay. Then the bad effect of vaccination. Other remedies, they are the antimtat, mesarium and the crotalus horridus. Now here the bad effect of vaccination leads to diarrhea. Now the sweat is on the uncovered part and eruption is on the covered part. Now sweat is only while the patient is sleeping. It stops when patient is awake. There is a toothache and it is because of the decay of the tooth and the tooth decay at the root. The crowns, they are intact. So here also the hiding feature is seen. That main part, which is the root, it is decay or it is not seen. What is seen is, the crown, and the crown is intact. Then the vertigo on closing the eyes. So these are the main key features of the Thuja that you have to remember. If you find this video helpful, then do let me know by your likes and comments. Do subscribe my YouTube channel Creative Materia Medica to learn the Materia Medica in very easy way. Turn on the bell icon to get the notification of all my videos. Share with your friends. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.